we see at sea is finely broken down plastics. We do know there's a lot of polyethylene and polypropylene, but that's just the stuff that we see floating at the surface.
About 11 years ago, back in 2000, I went to Midway Atoll. Every carcass I saw had plastic pouring out of its chest. Cigarette lighters. There were a toothbrush. Here's a shotgun shell. All of this stuff I pulled out of bird skeletons. And it struck me as deeply wrong, because I realized that this comes from my community. I use these products. This got me emotionally attached to the issue. I had to do something. I couldn't walk away and do nothing.
There's so much plastic out there that it's now starting to compete as a food source for many different organisms. So that's bringing up many questions right now in the scientific community. Are we literally eating our own trash through chemicals that stick to plastic, that get into the food chain, into the fish that you and I eat, and eventually into our bodies? So in terms of what's most commonly out there, we would say packaging and single-use disposables. But it's really difficult to engage people about the importance of these tiny little microplastic particles. What's interesting is that each particle of plastic has the potential to be a sponge for what we call persistent organic pollutants, POPs for short. And it's actually been shown that one single particle the size of a grain of rice can have up to a million times higher concentration of these pollutants than the water around it.
Toxins can desorb out of the plastic into the tissues and organs of the fish that are trying to eat those smaller fish. The toxins move up the food chain and they get more concentrated. And when you and I consume those bigger fish, the mahi-mahi, the tuna, what happens to us? Oceans are healthy, we are healthy. And that's the world I want to leave behind for the next generation.